Hello children, today once again we will continue with our lesson Animal Life. So we were doing different methods of breathing. Breathing is important for all the animals. We breathe in oxygen and we give out without carbon dioxide. The oxygen from the inhaled air is used to release the energy from the food, and carbon dioxide is breathed out during exhalation. There are two processes that take place during breathing, that is inhalation and exhalation. Now some animals breathe through lungs like mammals and birds. Some animals breathe through moist skin like earthworm frogs. Some animals breathe through holes, body holes. They are known as spiracles, and the examples are insects. And some animals breathe through gills. Examples are fish and tadpole. Now, this also I had explained it previously. Once again, I'll give you the quick revision of this, that this is the respiratory system, you can say, of human beings. There are two lungs. Animals like mammals and birds and reptiles, they breathe through their lungs, and they have got two lungs which are connected by a breathing tube. Okay, this blue color is the breathing tube, and which is connected to the nostrils. Here it is connected to the lungs. And when we inhale, the air gets filled into the lungs, and the lungs becomes big. And then the oxygen is released, it gets mixed with the food, and the carbon dioxide which is produced in the body, that is given out during exhalation when we breathe out, and then the lungs constricts. Okay, here in inhalation the lungs are expanded, you can see in the picture. So this is how the breathing in with the lungs takes place. Now some animals breathe through moist skin. As I told you that the animals breathe through, there are different systems. So the animals which breathe through moist skin are the animals which live in the, mostly they have got the moist skin. Like here the example is earthworm. Okay, so the exchange of gases takes place through this moist skin. Frog also breathe through the moist skin when it is in the water, and when on land it breathes through its lungs. Another way of breathing is through body holes, and insects breathe through these body holes, and they are called as spiracles. You can see the diagram. See here, small holes are shown. Through these holes, the exchange of these holes. So exchange of gases takes place through these holes. The air enters through these holes, and other air also reaches. After entering, it reaches all parts of the body through these small tubes, and also given out through these holes only. So this is how the animals breathe through body holes. Another way of breathing is through gills. And the picture very well you can see is of the fish. Fish, tadpoles, prawns, and most animals that live in water breathe through gills. And what do they breathe? They breathe the air which is dissolved in the water. Okay, have you seen dolphins? They come up to the on the surface of the air or surface of the water. Why? To take in the air. If they feel the air is not sufficient into the water, oxygen is not sufficient into the water, they come up, they jump, and they come up, they take in the oxygen, again go in the water. So this is about the dolphins. But here the picture is shown is of the fish, and the gills are also shown. They have gills instead of lungs, and they take in water through their mouth, As the water passes over the gills, the dissolved oxygen is taken in. Means the exchange of gases, the oxygen is taken in and carbon dioxide is given out. In the picture also you can see here is the gills. From the mouth the water is taken out, taken in, and then the oxygen gets the dissolved oxygen, which is dissolved in the air, in the water, it is taken in by the body and carbon dioxide is given out. So this is how the breathing takes place through gills. Now after this, there are different methods of moving. Means movement. Okay, you know, how do we move? We move with our limbs, right? Our legs and hands are known as limbs. And animals, why do animals have to move? Animals have to move to look for the food and also to escape from the enemies and to find shelter from heat, rain and cold. You know, to find shelter, to escape from the enemies and for the food, they move. Animals move. But they move in different ways. Different animals move in a different ways, that you know. Because some are land animals, some are water animals, some are aerial animals, means they which live in the air. So some move, while some move slowly, some move fast. Some can move over small distances, while some can move over long distances. Now, so we will discuss one after another. So first, many animals. First, the movement on the land. Many animals move on the land and they move with the help of limbs, as I told you. And the examples are lions, tigers, elephants, you know, all mostly, okay, land animals, they move on their limbs. Now, there are four limbs, right? Okay, means two pairs of limbs. The front limbs are called the fore limbs, F-O-R-E, fore limbs. And the one that are behind are known as hind limbs. Okay, so these wild animals, they use all the fore limbs to walk. Means fore limbs and hind limbs are both used to do the movement. See here. Okay, but humans can stand upright and walk on two legs. Okay. Other two, our arms are our fore limbs and our legs are our hind limbs. So we use only two limbs to walk. See here. And another thing, the arrangement of the thumb on our arms, on our hands, there are fingers. Okay, the fingers help us to grab anything. You can catch anything. Okay, and the position of the finger is such that it is at the opposite side. You can see the fingers are on the one side and other side is the thumb. The position of the thumb is such that we can hold anything, right? Only with these fingers we cannot hold properly. So anything, if you want to hold anything, to grab anything, we make use of our finger. Of our thumb. So the arrangement in humans is such that we are able to lift or hold or grab any things. Okay, now about the wild animals, you can see the picture here. Cheetah, horses, zebras are good runners. See the cheetah, how leopard it is running fast. You know, it is the fastest running animal. It can run very fast and because their legs are strong. See here, rabbit and hares, they hop. They cannot walk, they hop. Okay, their hind limbs are strong and longer than their fore limbs. See, you can see in the picture the hind limbs here, the hind limbs are longer than these fore limbs, right? So they can hope, right? Another animals like reptiles, you know, snakes and worms, they do not have legs, they crawl. Okay, a snake moves by curving and straightening. First it will curve and then straight up. So like this, it can move. Even a worm shortens and elongates. Means it goes first and then elongates. Means in like that can crawl on the, move some distance on the land. Right? And repeatedly by doing this, they can move some distance. Right? Look here, crocodiles, lizards and tortoise use their four short legs to crawl. They have got short legs. Reptiles, they do not have any legs, but here they have got here short, crocodiles and lizards and tortoise use their short legs. You can see in the picture, see here, these are the short legs. Now insect, what about insect? Insect has got six legs, okay, and they make use of these legs to walk. Like ants and beetles, you can see the picture and the legs also. The grasshopper uses its powerful hind legs to hop. Okay, it doesn't, it can hop. And others can walk. You must have seen many ants walking, right? So these are the animals that can move on land with the help of limbs. Now animals that fly, you know, birds can fly, very simple. So birds use their wings to fly, and the wings are actually the forelimbs, but they are modified in such a way that they are able to fly. They become their wings, and by moving the wings up and down, the bird push themselves through the air. Okay, it cuts the air currents, the flapping, by flapping the wings, and then it takes off. Okay, and it can fly, and because of that, because of the ability to fly, the bird's bodies are not heavy, they are light. You know, the bodies of birds are small and light, so that it becomes easy for them to fly. Okay, if the body is heavy, then it will not be able to fly. Even their bones, you know, their bones are hollow. Okay, there is air inside their bones, so that their body is light. Even they eat little, you know, they eat small portion in small intervals, so that their body is light and it makes it easy for them to fly. But there are some birds which cannot fly at all. Okay, they have forgotten to fly, you know, because, and these birds are known as flightless birds. Okay, birds like ostrich, emu, cassowary, they cannot fly because of that their bodies are heavy. You can say that because their bodies are heavy, they are not able to fly. Okay, they can run on the land, and their wings are also not properly developed. They are poorly developed wings, and their bodies are heavy. So these are known as flightless birds. Now one more method of moving is the animals who can swim. Okay, means swimming. While swimming, they can move. So fish, you know, fish swim by moving their body and tail from side to side. You know, you must have seen many times in aquarium in the ponds and rivers also movement of the fish. Okay, fishes have three types of fins that are used to balance, change direction, and stop. Okay, they can stop whenever they want, they can change their direction and swim. Some fish also use their fins like oars to push the water to move forward. There are water currents, they have to push, make way into the water. So to push the water, they use the fins like just as the oars. Okay. Then frogs also swim by kicking the water with their webbed hind legs. Their hind legs are webbed. Okay, there is some amount of skin in their hind legs, and they becomes webbed, and because of that they also, it also works like the oars. Okay, so fox swim by kicking the water with their webbed hind legs. The water boatman is an insect that uses its legs as oars to swim. Okay, then prawns and tadpoles swim with their legs. Turtles use their flippers for swimming, and penguins also. See, you can see the picture is there of the penguin. Penguins have wings that work like flippers. These are the, see here, this one. Okay, so these are the, you can say these are the wings that work like the flippers and are used for the swimming. So this is how the birds, the animals can swim in the water and they can do the movement. I hope you understood until here. Next class, we will again continue with the movement, and I'll also give you a quick revision of the previous lessons. Until then, take care and thank you.